Tesla Motors, seeking to expand its business beyond electric cars, will announce late Thursday a push into stationary battery units for homes and businesses. With the $5 billion battery Gigafactory under construction outside of Reno, creating a business around stationary batteries energy moves Tesla past focusing entirely on batteries for its electric cars. Storage batteries could become a huge business because they solve a big problem related to renewable energy. Sure, rooftop solar cells generate juice during the sunny afternoon, but what about the evening? The extra energy can be stored in batteries to power homes and businesses after the sun goes down. Demand will be helped along by a California Public Utilities Commission mandate that generators of electric power have stationary storage units. What Tesla is doing is an all-in strategy to bring the clean air revolution to the state. And as California goes, so goes the nation, says Roland Huang, Energy and Transportation Program Director for the Natural Resources Defense Council. Tesla CEO Elon Musk is also chairman of Solar City, a solar energy provider, which now also offers stationary battery units. Solar City says it has sold 300 units already this year. Tesla hasn't been trying hard to keep its big battery plans a secret. In a job posting for a development operations engineer, Tesla says it has developed a business unit to address the increasing need for stationary storage battery systems, which allows for even higher levels of renewable generation. Analyst Brian Johnson of brokerage Barclays says Tesla disclosed last year that it plans to devote nearly a third of the 15 capacity of its coming battery factory to stationary batteries. We'll see if that happens, he says. Another analyst, Ben Callow of Baird Equity Research, says in a note that developing a stationary storage business can only be good news. We believe entering storage will allow Tesla to more rapidly grow the company while diversifying its revenue streams, he wrote. Tesla was trading below $190 a share at the start of April, but it closed Thursday at $226.05 a share, down $6.40 or 2.75%.